Suffering is a part of life. I don't mean to be glib, and as one who has suffered and who often accompanies others through their suffering, what I'm saying is that like joy, suffering is a part of our lives. As Christians, we are often faced with the question, where is God in this? Or as one spiritual directee accompanying his wife and newborn through a trauma with little possibility of easy healing, recently said to me, Jim, I believe in God. I just don't think God cares. In the scripture reading offered for this meditation, Jesus is crying out to God, why have you forsaken me? Where are you when I need you most? A Trappist monk once told me that Jesus had to die. He just had to die. If God had reached down and lifted Jesus from his passion and death, we all humanity, really, would be able to say, oh, sure, Jesus, you don't really know the suffering I'm going through. But he did. He suffered death. We have a God who understands and who is willing to be with us in our pain and in our suffering. Many of us have cried the same cry or accompanied others in their suffering cries. I mean, cried out in pain with the kind of suffering that feels like it will never end, making us feel alone, far from a loving God. Even in our sleep, as an ancient Greek wrote, pain that cannot be forgotten falls drop by drop upon the heart, and in our despair, against our will, comes the presence of God by way of an awful grace. We have been present also at the realization by others of this awful grace. Jesus never said, you will not suffer alone. He said, I am with you always until the end of time, even when it doesn't seem that way. A writer who lost his wife and children in a horrific car accident put it this way, though I experienced death, I also experienced life in ways that I never thought possible before. Not after the darkness, as we might suppose, but in the darkness. I did not go through pain and come out on the other side. Instead, I lived in it and found within that pain the grace to survive and eventually to grow, to absorb evil and good, to die and to live again, to suffer abandonment and to find God. In choosing to face the night, he wrote, I took my first steps toward the sunrise. We sit with others in their suffering, as David Brooks said, simply sit, being practical, human, simple, and direct. Though I have often left you, God, you have not left me. Your mornings break, dear God, and earthly shadows flee. Abide in me, dear God, in life and death. Abide in me.